Hello everyone, this is a response video to a video made by MinutePhysics where he seemed to prove that infinity is equal to minus one. Which doesn't seem right to me. Well, he's a physicist, he could probably call that experimental error. But let's see what we can do about this. What he did is he took the infinite series 1 plus 2 plus 4 plus 8 plus 16, so each time it doubles, and he added that all together, and he said that that was obviously infinity. Which is fine, okay, I'm with that. And then he doubled the whole thing. So all the terms get doubled, again, that's fine. Then he subtracted one from the other. So on the left-hand side, he's got just S there. On the right-hand side, everything cancels out. So what he's left with is just the one, he subtracts that, so he gets minus one on the right-hand side. And that's fine. So he's saying S equals minus one, or to put it another way, infinity is equal to minus one. Now, I believe when you finish doing one of these troll maths, you're supposed to say, problem, and then smile like this. So this type of series is called a geometric series, where each term gets multiplied by a common factor. In our case, we were doubling it each time. But what about if we halved it each time? So you had 1 plus a half plus a quarter plus an eighth plus a sixteenth. So each term was getting smaller and smaller, going towards zero. Then we add all that together. If we did that, the partial sums are getting closer and closer to a value of 2. So we say that the value 2 is the limit of the series. And we call the series a convergent series. Now, the example we were doing with the terms doubling each time is clearly not a convergent series. So it's called a divergent series. Now, divergent doesn't just mean it's going off to infinity. It actually means anything that isn't convergent. So that might include things that are periodic as well, things that are flipping between two values. Now, it turns out that we can give divergent series a value as well. Now, it's not the limit, because there is no limit that it's going towards, but let's have a look at some values we can give divergent series. So we're looking for something that we can apply to divergent series so that it gives me a value. It could be anything as simple as, give me the first term of the series. But it would be more meaningful if the method that we pick gives me the limit when you also apply it to convergent series. So let's take a general geometric series. So each term is being multiplied by a common factor r. Now we can do the same tricks we did before. I'm going to multiply the whole thing by the common factor r and then subtract, and you do get a formula. You get s equals a over 1 minus r. Now these tricks only work to find you the limit of the series if the series is convergent in the first place. So the limit has to exist in order to find it. So for the limit to exist, each term has to be getting smaller and smaller. In other words, the common ratio has to be less than 1. If the series is divergent, you can still apply that formula and you'll get a value. But it won't be the limit of the series because the limit doesn't exist. So when you apply the formula to convergent series, you get the limit. So when the common ratio was a half, we got the limit of 2. When you apply the formula to divergent series, you get a value. So when I applied it when the common ratio was 2 and it was doubling each time, I got the value minus 1. Now that's not the limit because the limit doesn't exist. It's what the limit would be if it was a convergent series. Now, if the common ratio was minus 1, now that's quite interesting, because that means that the sequence is flipping between two values. It might be flipping between 5 and minus 5, 5 and minus 5, 5 and minus 5. So when you add up the partial sums, that's flipping as well. You get 5, 0, 5, 0. If you apply the formula then, you actually get the average of the partial sums. In that case, it would be 2.5. Now that's interesting too. So the average of partial sums is something that we could apply to all series. Now when you apply it to convergent series, it actually coincides with the limit. When you apply it to divergent series, you don't get the limit, but you get this average of partial sums. Either way, this value will have meaning. So what was the problem with the original video made by MinutePhysics? Well, the problem was he was using a method that you can apply to all geometric series. When you apply it to a convergent geometric series, you get the limit of the series. But he was applying it to a divergent geometric series. Now that's fine, and he was getting a value, which again is fine. But then he was saying that that value was the limit of the series. And that's not fine, because the limit does not exist. And there you have it. And for an encore, I will now debunk the myth that mathematicians are cool. Done. And if you have been, thanks for watching.